Hi there, welcome to another 5-minute tip. This tip was actually brought to me by one of my viewers. His name is Sean, and he responded to one of my YouTube videos asking about corrugated tubing and some ideas for techniques. This is what I came up with, and I thought it was a pretty good tip, so I decided to record it. The idea was that you wanted some corrugated tubing. You can see here that I've modeled one section of it. And the only thing I've really done specially is I have taken special care to make sure that the bottom edge of the tubing is exactly aligned with the axis of the object. We'll see why in a second. And to do that, I just used a rectangular selection, selected all these points here at the bottom, and I made sure that they had a Y position of 0. Now, the question was, how can you get this to be nice and repeatable along a spline? So I have two different splines here. I have one that's sort of angular with some chamfered corners, and then I've got a very organic three-dimensional spline. We're going to use both of these as examples, and let's get started. The first step that I thought of was that this is going to need to be repeatable, and the best way to do that in Cinema 4D right now is with a cloner. So now that you have a cloner, we can take our cylinder, place it as a child. By default, the cloner is going to repeat it 3 times, and it's going to just use sort of a default offset. Now we know how much our offset should be. It's equal to the height of our polygonal object. So we can get that right here in the Y size, because this is the Y axis pointing upwards. In the cloner, we can now say that our offset amount is Y axis 72.708, the same size as the object. And what this does is it gives us the ability to simply drag the slider to make this section longer or shorter. So that's step one. Now this has left us with an interesting problem. Because it's repeating, there's actually a visible seam. Now, as the grayscale gorilla has shown us in the past, and also in some of my tutorials, we can get rid of that seam really easily using the connect object. So if I grab a connect object and place the cloner inside of it, the seam goes away. So that's a good start. And we now have a piece of tubing we can easily adjust the length of, and when we adjust the length of it, it just sort of joins itself, and it's always nice and smooth. So that's a good place to be. Let's give it a nice color so we can see it a little bit better. Just going to place a nice red material on the connect object. There we go. Now we have this object and we have these splines and we want to move it along the spline. Well, this part is pretty easy, and you guys might have seen me do this in my taping cables together tutorial. We use a spline wrap deformer, and after tweaking a few settings we can get it to go along these paths pretty well. So the way the spline wrap works is it needs to be in the same hierarchy as the object we want to deform. So I'm going to select the spline wrap and the connect object and group them. So they're now siblings. And that means the spline wrap is going to influence the connect object. Now in the spline wrap, we can then drag the straight spline into it. And we see that all of a sudden things get crazy. So it's correctly moving it along the spline, deforming it that is, but it's doing it in such a way that it's on the wrong axis. It's almost tilted on its side. Super easy to fix. We can just change the axis from X to Y. There we go. So our object is now being swept along our spline, but it's not really the right length. It's sort of being stretched. So in the spline wrap, the settings I like to use are for the mode, fit the spline, and for the end mode, I like to use clamp. You can use clamp or extend, I suppose, but for this demo, let's use clamp. And what we can do is in our cloner, we can say, okay, instead of 4 segments, let's do 12 segments. It's 12 clones, that is. So now our object is being swept along the spline. We can just increase the number of clones, and it sort of increases the density of our object. All the while, it's being really neatly deformed along the spline. So that's the tip. It's a really simple one. It's worth mentioning that it works on organic splines like this one as well. So we can select our spline wrap object and change the spline to the curvy one. And now it deforms along the curvy one. Whoops. I got twisted around there. Yeah, so now it deforms along the curvy one. And likewise, we can change this to 40 clones. It's going to take a little while to process. It slows down a little bit when you increase the number of clones. And there we go. We have the corrugated object along the spline, and it looks pretty good. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tip. If you want to see more like this, let me know. And until next time, see ya.